Hello students, in previous lecture we have studied about the evaluation of management thoughts and we have explored different management schools in different management eras. Again, we had a brief introduction about scientific management school and the work done by F.W. Taylor. So, in this module, we will be discussing about what scientific management is. Founder of scientific management, that is F.W. Taylor's work in this field, principles and elements of scientific management given by F.W. Taylor, and what are the different criticisms faced by scientific management. So let's get started. So these are the major learning outcomes of this module. After completion of this module, you will be able to define what scientific management is, understand principles and elements of scientific management, and understand criticisms to the scientific management. So, scientific management implies the application of science to management. It means conduct of business activities according to pattern through standardized tools, methods, and trained personnel in order to increase the output, improve its quality, reduce the cost and waste. A few definitions of the concept of scientific management are given here. So according to Taylor, Taylor defines scientific management as: scientific management is concerned with knowing exactly what you want men to do and then see in that they do it in the best and cheapest way. So this is the definition of scientific management given by Taylor. According to Kimball and Kimball, it is an attitude that aims to replace I think with I know. It points out the method of intelligently directing the construction and arrangement of factory buildings, the character of methods and processes, the organization of departments, the elimination of waste and increase of efficiency in all phases of industrial administration where data and experience are applicable. Again, according to Harlow Pearson, scientific management characterizes that form of organization and procedure is purposive effort which rests on principles or laws derived by process of scientific investigations and analysis instead of tradition or policies determined empirically and casually by the process of trial and error. Again, Jones defined scientific management as: it is a body of rules together with their appropriate expression in physical and administrative mechanisms and specialized executives to be operated in coordination as a system for the achievement of new strictness in the control and processes of production. Again, according to Spriegel, scientific management, when conceived as a body of knowledge, is based upon the careful formulation of basic laws or procedures in such phases of human endeavor, processes, and material. Scientific management, viewed as a process or a method, is concerned primarily with the discovery of causal relationships between efforts expended for a given objective and the results of these efforts, with special emphasis upon the discovery of the best method in the light of the available manpower, materials, and technology. So these are the some definitions of scientific management. The concept of scientific management was introduced by Frederick Winslow Taylor, widely known as F.W. Taylor. F.W. Taylor was the first person who insisted on the introduction of scientific methods in management. And it was he who, along with his associates, made the first systematic study of management. He launched a new movement in the year 1910, which is called scientific management. That is why टेलर इज नोन एज द फादर ऑफ साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट. फ्रेडरिक विंस्लो टेलर वॉज अ पायोनियर हु प्रोपोंडेड साइंटिफिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एज द रिजल्ट ऑफ हिज कीन रिसर्च इन डिफरेंट एरियाज ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल एक्टिविटीज. ही वॉज प्राइमरली कंसर्न विद द इफिशियंसी ऑफ वर्कर्स एंड ऑप्टिमम यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ मशीन्स एंड अदर रिसोर्सेस इन ऑर्डर टू ब्रिंग अप अ साउंड एंटरप्राइज कंसिस्टेंट विद द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ एंटरप्रेनर्स द लेबरर्स एंड द कंज्यूमर्स एट लार्ज. टेलर हु वर्क्ड इन डिफरेंट कैपेसिटीज इन स्टील इंडस्ट्री सॉ द अर्जेंट नेसेसिटी फॉर एलिमिनेशन ऑफ वेस्ट रैम्पेंट इन द इंडस्ट्रियल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. The only way to avoid waste and achieve efficiency was, he felt, to apply methods of science to the fields of management. He found by his observation and experiments in factories where he worked that methods of production lacked planning, tools and equipments were old, and working methods were haphazard. Taylor published books and papers explaining his radical views on industrial organization and management, shop management, piece rate per system, principles of scientific management, were his major contributions to management thought. Taylor came to be recognized as the father of scientific management and was hailed as the creator of new science. So Taylor has contributed in scientific management in two ways. He gave elements and tools of scientific management, and he also gave the principles of scientific management. So let's first see the different elements of scientific management. So different elements of scientific management are separation of planning and doing, functional foremanship, job analysis, standardization, scientific selection and training of workers, financial incentives, economy, and last one is mental revolution. Now let's see each element in detail one by one. So the first element of scientific management is separation of planning and doing. So according to F.W. Taylor, he thought that planning aspect of work should be separated from actual doing of work. Taylor felt that the workers restricted their output because of the major reason that there was no standard about proper day's work. Hence, it is essential to set the standard task which on average workers should do during a day. Taylor termed it as a fair day's work. Taylor emphasized the need for planning work. He advocated that planning function should be separated from the executive function. Workers should not be supposed to choose their own method and decide what they have to do. The detailed planning should be done by planning department. So, the planning department should prepare detailed instruction for the workers as to the type, shape, quality and quantity of the products to be produced. Again, they should lay down the machines and equipments to be used. Planning department should determine the time required for completion of various operations. They should make available the necessary materials and tools in carrying out the operations. Again, they should receive feedback information for the modification of planning if it is necessary. Second element of scientific management is functional foremanship. Now, as in the first element, we saw that there was separation of planning and doing. So basically, the supervisor now handed over additional responsibility of planning apart from simply supervision. So basically, they now work almost double and they have to do extra work. So Taylor, he evolved a concept of functional foremanship based on the specialization of the functions. What are the different supervisors are required to do? He specialized those functions. So basically, he divided these functions of supervisors into 8 different categories. So 8 persons are involved to direct the activities to the workers. So as we can see, a factory manager, under that he has 2 different categories of supervisors. One is planning in charge and other is production in charge. Now in the planning in charge, he has 4 different supervisors. One is instruction card clerk, other is routine clerk, third is time and cost clerk, and fourth one is disciplinary clerk. Now in the production in charge, he again has 4 supervisors. One is gang boss, one is repair boss, other is inspector and speed boss. Now the job of instruction card clerk was basically to tag down all the instructions according to which worker perform their jobs. Job role of the route clerk was to determine the route through which the raw material has to be passed. The time and cost clerk was concerned with setting the timetable for doing job and specifying the materials and and labor cost which is involved in it. While the disciplinarian, he was involved or concerned with making rules and regulations to ensure the discipline is followed in the organization. Again, in the production in charge, first one was gang boss. He basically made arrangement of workers, materials, machines and tools. Repair boss was concerned with maintenance of machines, tools and equipments. Inspector was basically concerned with maintaining quality, and the last, speed boss, was concerned with maintaining the speed and basically removes the delays in production processes. So that is how he divided functions of supervisors into 8 different categories. And this is what functional foremanship is all about. The third element of scientific management is job analysis. It was undertaken to find out the one best way of doing the things. That is, so that it can be standardized, or things can be standardized, or work can be standardized, and the best way could be determined by taking up time, motion and fatigue studies. Now, time studies involves determination of time. That is, a movement done by the worker and how much time it takes, and depending on that, he standardized time taken for doing various activities. Motion study involves study of movements, that is, what are the different movements done by the workers, and if there are any wasteful movement, how can we eliminate that? So this is what motion study concerned about. And fatigue study shows the amount of frequency and frequency of rest required for completing the work. Earlier, workers used to take rest whenever they wanted, and time also was not fixed, but according to Taylor, he fixed the time and frequency of the rest. Next element of scientific management is standardization. The following things should be fixed in advance in case of standardization. Standardization should be maintained in respect of instruments, tools, period of work, amount of work to do, different working conditions and cost of productions. The fifth element of scientific management was scientific selection and training of workers. Taylor suggested that workers should be selected on scientific basis. That is, they have to take into the account their education, work experiences, physical strength required for the job, etc. All these criteria should be considered while selecting the worker. A worker should be given the work for which he is physically and technically most suitable. It should not be like that. Any worker is given any job, and proper emphasis should be also be given on the training and workers. The sixth element of scientific management is financial incentives. It is very important element to motivate workers. It can basically motivate workers to put their maximum efforts. So Taylor, he again developed a concept of differential piece rate system. Under this piece rate system, the worker who completed his job, he used to get a higher rate or higher wage, and one who does not complete gets a lower rate. Earlier, workers used to get the same amount of wage no matter how much work they had done in a day. So Taylor suggested that if a worker performs better, he should be paid higher, and if he does not perform better, he should be paid lower. He suggested that wages should be based on individual performance and should not be on standard, and they should not be standardized. Next element of scientific management is economy. Taylor not only considered scientific and technical aspect, but he also gave importance to economy and profit. So techniques of cost estimates and controls should be adapted, and economy can be achieved by making the resources more productive and by eliminating the wastages. Last element of scientific management is mental revolution. It suggested that scientific management is dependent on mutual cooperation of management and workers. There should be a mental change in both the parties from conflict to cooperation. This is the most important feature of scientific management, because in its absence, no principles of scientific management can be applied. So these are the elements of scientific management. So let's now move to the principles of scientific management. So first principle of scientific management is replacing rule of thumb with science. Next is harmony in group actions. Again, cooperation. Fourth one is maximum output. And fifth principle is development of workers. So let's see each principle in detail. So first principle of scientific management is replacing rule of thumb with science. Taylor has emphasized that in scientific management, organized knowledge should be applied which will replace rule of thumb. While the use of scientific method denotes precision in determining any aspect of work, rule of thumb emphasizes estimations. Since exactness of various aspects of work like day's fair work, standardization in work, differential piece rate of payment, etc. is the basic core of scientific management, it is essential that all these are measured precisely and should not be based on just estimates. Second principle is harmony in group action. Taylor has emphasized that attempts should be made to obtain harmony in group action rather than discord. Group harmony suggests that there should be mutual give and take situation and proper understanding so that a group as a whole contributes to the maximum. Next principle is cooperation. Scientific management involves achieving cooperation rather than chaotic individualism. Scientific management is based on mutual confidence, cooperation, and goodwill. Cooperation between management and workers can be developed through mutual understanding and a change in thinking. Taylor has suggested substitution of war for peace, heartly or brotherly cooperation for discontentment and strife, replacement of suspicious watchfulness with mutual confidence of becoming friends instead of enemies. It is along this line I say that scientific management is must deployed. Fourth principle of scientific management is maximum output. Scientific management involves continuous increase in production and productivity instead of restricted production either by management or by worker. टेलर हेटेड इनइफिशियंसी एंड डेलिबरेट कर्टेलमेंट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. हिज कंसर्न वॉज विद द लार्ज साइज ऑफ द केक. इन हिज ओपिनियन देयर इज हार्डली एनी वर्स क्राइम टू माई माइंड दैट देन दैट ऑफ डेलिबरेटली रिस्ट्रिक्टिंग आउटपुट. ही एडवाइज्ड टर्न अटेंशन टुवर्ड्स इंक्रीजिंग द साइज ऑफ द सरप्लस अंटिल द साइज ऑफ द सरप्लस बिकम्स सो लार्ज दैट इज नेसेसरी टू क्वारल ओवर नाउ इट शैल बी डिवाइडेड. एंड द लास्ट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट इज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ वर्कर्स. इन साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट ऑल वर्कर्स शुड बी डेवलप टू द फुलेस्ट एक्सटेंट पॉसिबल फॉर देयर ओन एंड फॉर द कंपनीज हाइएस्ट प्रॉस्पेरिटी. डेवलपमेंट ऑफ वर्कर्स रिक्वायर्स देयर साइंटिफिक सिलेक्शन एंड प्रोवाइडिंग देम ट्रेनिंग एट द वर्क प्लेस. ट्रेनिंग शुड बी प्रोवाइडेड टू वर्कर्स टू कीप देम फुली फिट अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ न्यू मेथड्स ऑफ वर्किंग विच मे बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द नॉन साइंटिफिक मैनेज मेथड्स. सो दीज आर द फाइव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट. सो लेट्स मूव टू द क्रिटिसिजम्स फेस्ड बाय साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट. सो देर आर थ्री क्रिटिसिजम्स विच कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज ऑब्जेक्शंस बाय वर्कर्स, ऑब्जेक्शंस बाय एम्प्लॉयर्स एंड ऑब्जेक्शंस बाय साइकोलॉजिस्ट. सो ऑब्जेक्शंस ऑफ वर्कर्स साइंटिफिक टू द साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट कैन बी समराइज एज इट लीड्स अकॉर्डिंग टू वर्कर्स दे से दैट साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट लीड्स टू लॉस ऑफ इनिशिएटिव इन्वेंटिव स्किल्स एंड इंडिपेंडेंट जजमेंट ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ वर्कर्स एंड एग्जीक्यूटिव पर्सनल सिंस दे आर जस्ट टू कैरी आउट द इंस्ट्रक्शंस इम्पोज बाय प्लानर्स. सेकेंड ऑब्जेक्शन वॉज दैट मिनट प्लानिंग माइन्यूट प्लानिंग स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन एंड टाइट कंट्रोल रिड्यूस द वर्कर्स टू ब्लाइंड मशीन. अगेन द ऑब्जेक्ट दैट वर्कर्स आर स्पीडेड अप विदाउट फंडामेंटल इम्प्रूवमेंट्स इन फैक्ट्री लेआउट प्रोडक्शन टेक्निक्स टूल डिजाइन्स ट्रेनिंग एक्सेट्रा. दिस एंडेंजर्स द हेल्थ ऑफ वर्कर्स एंड क्रिएट्स हार्मफुल मेंटल टेंशन इन देम. अकॉर्डिंग टू वर्कर साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट इज एप्रिहेंडेड दैट अडॉप्शन ऑफ लेबर सेविंग टेक्निक्स इन मैनेजमेंट दैट विल लीड टू अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. न्यूमरस वर्कर्स विल बी रेंडर्ड सुपरफ्लुअस बिकॉज ऑफ कंप्यूटराइजेशन एंड मैकेनाइजेशन ऑफ मैनेजरियल एक्टिविटीज. टेक्नोलॉजिकल अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट एज इट मे बी कॉल्ड कुड कॉज सोशल इम्बैलेंस. इट इज एलिज्ड दैट साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट वुड ब्लॉक द ग्रोथ ऑफ ट्रेड यूनियंस. साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट मे ब्रिंग इन मैनेजरियल डिक्टेटरशिप. इट मे बिकम एंटी डेमोक्रेटिक बिकॉज इट ओवरशेडोज द वर्कर्स इंडिपेंडेंस. डिसीजन मेकिंग पावर्स विल बी कंसंट्रेटेड हेवीली इन मैनेजमेंट एंड एक्सपर्ट्स. देर इज एवरी लाइकलीहुड ऑफ मिसयूज ऑफ दिस अथॉरिटी एंड ट्विस्टिंग ऑफ डेटा टू द डिट्रीमेंट ऑफ वर्कर्स. सो सेकंड ऑब्जेक्शन वॉज बाय एम्प्लॉयर्स. एम्प्लॉयर थॉट दैट इट इन्वॉल्व्स एडिशनल हेवी कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट रिसर्च टाइम एंड मोशन स्टडीज स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन एंड अदर प्रोग्राम्स ऑफ साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट वुड मीन हायर कैपिटल आउटले. अकॉर्डिंग टू एम्प्लॉयर्स ओनली लार्ज स्केल एंटरप्राइजेस विथ एश्योर्ड मार्केट कैन डेराइव बेनिफिट ऑफ साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट. स्मॉलर एंटरप्राइजेस कैन नॉट अफोर्ड टू अडॉप्ट द न्यूअर टेक्निक्स बिकॉज ऑफ देयर प्रोहिबिटिव कॉस्ट. अगेन दे थॉट दैट द रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ द वर्कर्स टू द न्यू सिस्टम्स मे बी अनसर्टन एंड इनएडिक्वेट. इफ द वर्कर्स डू नॉट शो ड्यू इंटरेस्ट इन इम्प्लीमेंटिंग द रिफॉर्म्स द इन्वेस्टमेंट्स इन द मशीन्स स्टैंडर्ड टूल्स ट्रेनिंग एंड गाइडेंस ऑफ वर्क पीपल वुड बी अ वेस्ट अ बर्डन ऑन द मैनेजमेंट. मैनेजमेंट विल बी अनवाइडली एंड इट मे नॉट बी पॉसिबल टू मेंटेन डिसिप्लिन एंड मोरल इन द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द एंटरप्राइज. अगेन एम्प्लॉयर्स थॉट दैट साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट मे लीड टू ओवर प्रोडक्शन और ग्लट स्लाइट रिसेशन इन द मार्केट वुड हिट द फर्म्स हेवीली. सो दीज आर द ऑब्जेक्शंस मेड बाय एम्प्लॉयर्स. अगेन देर आर सम साइकोलॉजिस्ट ऑब्जेक्शंस. अकॉर्डिंग टू साइकोलॉजिस्ट स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन टाइम एंड मोशन स्टडीज एंड फंक्शनल फॉर्मनशिप वुड रिड्यूस द वर्कर्स टू मेयर टूल इन द हैंड्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड इट्स एक्सपर्ट्स. वर्कर्स फील्स अ सेंस ऑफ इन्फेरियोरिटी कॉम्प्लेक्स वेन दे आर आस्क्ड टू फॉलो मैकेनिकली द इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ द प्लानर्स एंड एग्जीक्यूटिव्स विदाउट थिंकिंग ऑन देयर ओन. अगेन साइकोलॉजिस्ट थिंक दैट इवॉल्विंग द यूनिफॉर्म्स एंड द सुपेरियर मेथड फॉर ऑल वर्कर्स इज अगेंस्ट द टेनेट्स ऑफ साइकोलॉजी. द बेस्ट कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड इफ वर्कर्स आर गिवन स्कोप टू शेप देयर करियर्स अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर एप्टीट्यूड्स. द रोल ऑफ वर्कर अंडर साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट इन द स्कीम ऑफ प्रोडक्शन इज माइनर दो माइन्यूट. रिपीटेटिव परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द सेम जॉब वुड क्रिएट मोनोटोनी द परवर्स इफेक्ट ऑफ एक्सेस स्पेशलाइजेशन. Monotony is a mental state of slack efficiencies. Psychologists thought that absence of non-financial incentives is also a drawback of scientific management. So these are some drawbacks, or we can say that objections to the scientific management. Thank you.